options. We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones. That's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Now that's what you call a God complex. Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket. Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas. Ooh, I'm a mess, girl, I'm a. Ooh. It's all a finesse. Ooh. Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's no, I didn't got it.
Okay.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with their opponents. Not something you expect to see from the opening kickoff, that's for sure, and they will start at the 40.
All right, let's go. It's Tyrod Taylor time.
Jacobs now. Only a couple for him there.
Only
on
two?
The game's first play, and it's second down.
Okay, that might have been open there. These receivers, though.
Quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won
right
that
there.
Battle at the point of attack
right here. You know what? We can get Switzer the ball.
Leverage,
now they're going to give Callaway a chance.
And stacked him up.
We need somebody else to step up, these receivers. That's been the main problem we lost last time.
A four receiver look here.
You couldn't
three
get nothing
to the
going.
Left, one to the right on second and eight. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. Looking for his running back, and he's got it.
No, that worked.
He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
You know what I never get
a
chance to try it? Is this pistol formation? Let's see. There it is. I never got a chance to use this.
I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And
so
it's a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on.
Trying to get everybody involved.
Most of these guys are self motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
But like I said, this is my first time doing this YouTube thing. We're gonna see how it goes.
On first and 10, it's Taylor, and brought in by the tight end.
Definitely, gotta utilize everything. If this is your first time joining or watching, this is the 49ers and Connected franchise. We are utilizing Tyrod Taylor with an X factor. Tyrod Taylor never really got a fair shot in the NFL, I think, as a starter. He started for Bills team and led them to the playoffs, but everybody forgets that. And I think he recently punctured his lungs, if I'm not mistaken, by a doctor. So I think his career pretty much over for now. This is the normal team of the 49ers. The only difference is I made a trade for Michael Thomas to help out for the receiving corps and Latavius Murray and Jared Cook. We sent away Naheem Hines, I believe, for Josh Jacobs, which I think was a great trade for us. But that's really about it. Defense is okay. I want to try and build this team up a little bit. We're not expecting anything crazy. I don't expect anything crazy from them yet, you know. But we're gonna be realistic with it. I say I want to try to get at least 8 wins at the most with this team. I think we can do that and try to get that playoff appearance. Oh, he got a block right there on Barry, but he didn't hold it. I should have known. Couldn't have running back right there. Should have gotten a receiver.
Their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of.
We're gonna see
what this game continues.
What these receivers can do. I think Callaway is faster than Brandon Ayuk. I'm not sure. You got to find out. But I think he is. We will find out eventually. And Callaway's a Taylor. Callaway is a pretty good. Oh, that was a terrible throw on the run right there. Incomplete.
He was trying to get to Jerick McKinnon there, but now it'll be third down. A lot of times it's that first read that you have.
We just need another receiver to really step up and make some catches. But he was tried to use her. He dropped too many. He dropped too many easy passes in coverage, so I don't think he's going to be that guy we're looking for.
From the shotgun, it's Taylor.
So far, Ayuk has been the only one really consistently catching stuff. His route running is not high. His speed is I think 93, if I'm not mistaken. It's not crazy. So I went and picked up, or it's 94, I think. I went and picked up Callaway off of somebody's practice squad. He has 93 speed. We got Chris Sims. He's 6'5". He has like 90 speed. So we will try and build with him. Ryan Switzer, I'm not really sure. I watched him a lot in college at North Carolina. He's a great receiver, great slot receiver. But on the game, he hasn't really seen much success on here. But I don't know. We'll just have to see. Now, as far as defense goes, I don't know. I kind of like what we have. I just got to figure out the safeties. The corner spot is good. It's okay. It's not to my liking, though. But we're going to see. He got Joey Burrow back here.
Now Burrow on first down.
I just gotta figure out who's gonna be where. I don't think I have Richard Sherman. He has an age reduction. I just don't know. I just don't know if he should be playing. Actually, you know what? We messed that up last game. We're not gonna give him the same mistake. We're gonna put him back at safety. I don't have time to make the adjustments because I'm up. We're going to put him at safety because he gets beat on any short route. So we're going to put him up right here. Damn, they're not letting me move him. What the hell? Yes, of course.
They'll come up now, second and four from the.
So we're going to put him right there.
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow.
I think that was my coverage. I'm just not learning how to really use it. The middle of the field. It's not something I'm used to doing yet. I'm trying to learn how to do that. Miles Sanders is a pretty good running back. We got to slow him down. I think if we slow him down, there's not any great receivers on this. On that Eagles team, Jalen Reagor's pretty fast. Well, if you limit him and Goodwin, then I think we'll be in good shape.
We'll be fine. And try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
See right there, I gotta get that coverage with these linebackers. I had him. It's okay though. I'm satisfied with that.
The gun, it's Burrow, flush to his right.
You're gonna let him take that.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds.
That's really good coverage by Mosey right there. See, I'm trying to figure out if Mosey can take that spot right there from Sherman. Because Sherman is not the fastest on here. Hopefully, we can somehow get that. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks. Oh, he just ran right up the middle. That's my fault. I want to try and use a 3-4, but I don't have the linebackers for it. So we just got to stick with this. Unfortunately. Once we build these guys up, depending on how long this league lasts, we should be okay though. But that's gonna be the priority so far is stopping those guys.
From the shotgun, it's Burrow.
Ah, damn. He actually only rushed two on that one. That's an accident. I'm still learning these adjustments. Did not mean to do that.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
It's a gain of 17 yards. First down, Philadelphia.
Why did he not get that?
On first and 10, it's Sanders.
That's a good job.
Able to get about three as he's taken.
I want to put Bosa on the inside. I'm not sure. Oh,
there's not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
But yeah,
3 yards on that last carry.
Definitely
here's second
do that.
And seven. Forced out to his left.
Good job. That's a great job. Oh, he lagging. He is lagging. Hope you don't lag all game. Yep. He lagged out. Stream still on. Well, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock them down to their cold cases. Marathon run, I'm a slow pacing. They did not want me to go places. Foil clearance like the gold place. And if we pull it up with the whole squad, I get ready to go, y'all, that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing. If it's snow, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, body, young. Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. You barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me little, bro, I got money on me. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it. I'm passing your wild nonsense. We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones. That's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Now that's what you call a God complex. Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man. It feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket. Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas. Ooh, I'm a mess, but I'm a. It's all a finesse. Ooh. Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's snow, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, body, dumb. Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me low, bro, I got mileage on me. Walked in with the whole team, we riding on it. More action and no talk, I went quiet on it. Walked in with the whole team, we riding on it.
We're about 40 miles south of Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with their opponents. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Hey!
throw on first down with Taylor. He's got this to the rookie from ASU, Brandon Ayuk. The 20. Touchdown, 49ers. Brandon Ayuk, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Niners have taken the early lead. Wow, first play in the game, CD, 75 yards. These people, they haven't even filed in yet from the tailgate blocks.
Everyone talks about starting out fast. Everyone talks about getting explosive-type plays. That was absolutely a thunderbolt. And on the defensive side, you spent all week scheming, all week preparing, and it seems like it goes right out the window.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And Rager will not return it, so it'll come out to the 25 on the touchback.
25-yard line.
Play action. It's Burrow. And complete to Zach Ertz. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Boy, he ran free there after the catch as that winds up going for 38.
First down, Eagles.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Burrow, setting up to throw it. Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. First carry for Josh Jacobs. And he'll take this one up to about the 23.
The ball carrier.
Give the tackle that time to Rodney McLeod.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a 3rd and 3. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because right, they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool
looking
you.
Looking good, but start over.
Get your eyes in the wrong
but
y'all,
at this point, you already know what's going
right
on with this series.
He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice
like
play.
Like you again.
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on 3rd down. Trying to run for it with Jacobs.
If only Jacobs was faster, he'd better break stuff like that. I swear he'd really be able to break that.
First down. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go 3 and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you'll have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
On first down, hurry.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
That's the receivers that spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3.
And the play
goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down.
At the 39-yard line.
This time, Taylor will throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
48-yard line.
2 first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. DJ Reader there on the tackle.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
No. That's fine. Thank you.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh my God. Hey. Shit.
And with the play clock about to expire, Kyle Shanahan's going to use a timeout. And that's their 2nd charge timeout here in this 1st quarter. They're down to 1 remaining.
Damn it.
Taylor. This one into the hands of Hurd. And he has another 1st down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 36. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
It's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their 1st drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Play action. It's Taylor. The 1st catch of the game for George Kittle. And he has another 1st down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 14. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
George Kittle is easily one of the elite tight ends in the NFL. Back-to-back seasons of 88 and 85 catches. We just saw another one right there. Anytime he lines up on the field, you better treat him as a primary receiver and make sure you have a 2nd guy in the vicinity to try and cover it.
Touchdown, Callaway. Just picked him up free agency. He's making an immediate impact. Already off top. I love it.
His 1st touchdown on the year. And the 49ers had.
He's yet to make a catch, though. We're still trying to find that 3rd receiver to start. Michael Thomas is really just a damn decoy at this point. I'm going to try and get him the ball somehow.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep.
Man, he's not really needed or anything like that.
Line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. They're passing here. Joe Burrow eluding the pressure right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowl tight end Zach Ertz, the intended target, and it's third and five.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Now it's Burrow. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week.
Win. Sometimes you over game plan, overthink things. Get back to what works.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. On fourth down, out is the punter, Cameron Johnston, to boot it away. Back deep, Ryan Switzer. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything's working pretty well. For the defensive one,
on the defensive
that's
side.
A tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. One thing that's great about watching him run, Charles, he doesn't hesitate. He got to the left side of his own line and just went.
So there's two ways to look at that. One, just absolutely unconcerned, just takes off and goes. But more the latter, I think, which
well,
is
well, right
he
now,
absolute
playing an undefeated
the
opponent.
In front of him, the guy's doing the blocking.
But I've already had a 21-7 lead on somebody, so that doesn't really mean anything. You got to keep up on it, guys.
Try and set up the screen. It's complete.
Oh, that's a great tackle.
7 yards there on the first down.
We gotta keep
play.
Our foot on the gas.
Screen pass looked like it was coming
sure.
together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Cannot let up. Cannot give him a chance to score. Making some bad passes so far, but we just gotta clean up everything on the line and watch out for Sanders. Like
able
I said,
to get
should be able
on
to win
that
this game.
First down pass play, second and three. Here's Jacobs.
Oh, yeah, that's it. It's easy money.
Down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 yards there and a first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success.
Man, you got to move out the way, man.
At the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
On the play, second and 10 at the Eagles' 24-yard line.
Here's Taylor. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he
what?
Was out of bounds. So a big call there. That brings up fourth.
Fourth down.
Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. From the left hash, this from 37.
That was definitely inbounds, but okay.
Season, he's able to get this one to go. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. And they go play action now. Burrow. And he's got his man in stride. Complete.
Burrow's
given 2 yards on that play. And they're going to face a 3rd down.
A gain of 2 on the play. And this is 3rd.
Here's Burrow. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he is going to have an Eagles 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. It was 3rd and short, and they go flying past the marker for a gain of nearly 30 yards. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Burrow will throw. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. Rookie to rookie on the hook up there, and it's a 1st down.
1st down, Philadelphia.
Now Sanders. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
On 2nd down, it's Sanders. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
Sanders again, the ball carrier.
18 yards there, and it'll be a 1st and goal. And now the Niners going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this 2nd quarter. The Eagles into the red zone for the 1st time. They've got a 1st and goal just inside the 5. Now Burrow. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley. And the Niners are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. 1:52 to play until halftime. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
3-yard line.
18 yards, 1st down Niners. They run it with Jacobs. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The Niners have the 1st down on a gain of 11.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Same exact result as last play. A pickup of 11. Now they'll run. Murray Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. Second and goal, and they will try again from the two-yard line. They'll try to run this one in, and he's going to take it in.
Good job. Murray's been playing crazy.
San Francisco. Latavius Murray, his first touchdown on the year. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. Gold to add the extra point. And the lead is now 24.
Looking good. So far, so good. Now that I feel off the gas, I did that last time I played on here and I lost. This shit is never over. Two scores and a turnover and then back in the game. No, good kick.
Yeah, that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone.
Make sure we don't give up anybody here. Make sure you don't give up anything easy.
The offense sent to begin their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said is they went back out there.
Oh, Sherman could have gotten it, but that's a rip.
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football.
Oh, come on, we got to grab those.
Lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Burrow looking to pass.
Ah, come on. We got to grab that pick.
And he's going to have a first
right
down
there.
And they get into field goal range here at the 29. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Burrow on play action. And now Burrow going to be intercepted yet again. Picked by Tarvarius Moore.
What happened?
Tarvarius Moore.
Yeah, I didn't see it go to the back.
The first down pass. Intercepted. The Niners
and now we can't pick a play. This nigga is lagging. Come on, man.
Down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. So that'll back him up five. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Final play of the half, it's Taylor. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And he returns this to the 22.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. On second down now. It's Sanders. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football. In that situation, that's almost a tendency breaker.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He's got the first down as he went past midfield. And all the way down to the 41-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time, they get it to him in a more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
They go play action with Burrow. Hauled in over the middle by Rager. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Jalen Rager with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Eagles make some inroads here on that deficit.
Come on, this nigga shit go lag out in grief. Come on, can we finish the game, please? Can we finish the game?
Oh, look at this. They're not even going to get the two-point play off. Maybe too much indecision. It's going to cost them 5 yards.
This certainly feels like they were wanting to go for two, but weren't really sure they should go for two. Do we, don't we, do we, don't we? And guess what ends up happening?
5-yard penalty.
That's right. Now you probably line up and kick the extra point.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two.
Bro, this nigga shit keep lagging fucking out. Come on, man. Bro, come on, man. The fuck? Come on, man.
Yeah, before they can get the playoff, here's a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball. That's their first of this second half. No, but I'm on this every day.